Now we will see how loop unrolling works. Suppose we have this loop in the C language where I goes from 1000 down to 0, and in each iteration of the loop we add something to the ith element of the array A. When we translate this into instructions, we get a loop like the one we have already seen. We load from the array element, so R1 is now the pointer to the ith element of the array. We load that, we add R3, that would be RS, to that, and then we store it back into the A of I, and then we move our pointer 4 places down, that's equivalent to decrementing I, and then we check whether the pointer has reached the beginning of the array, which is equivalent to checking whether I is 0. Now let's apply loop unrolling to this loop. We will do what we call unrolling once. We unroll the loop by making each iteration of the new loop do more than one iteration of the old loop. So when we unroll once, what we want to do is now each iteration of the new loop will be doing the work that it should be doing plus the work of the next iteration. However, if we just do it this way, then we are doing the same work twice. So instead what we will do is we will adjust the index so that this is doing the ith element of the array, and then I would be decremented, and the next iteration would now do A of I minus 1. However, this loop still counts one at a time, so we do this, we add S to the next element. In the next iteration of the loop, we would now add S again to the same element we already processed here. So we also need to adjust the loop counter update to update by 2 now. And now we have a new loop that has half as many iterations, each of which is doing the work of the 2 original iterations. We could unroll the loop more than once. For example, unrolling 2 times would mean that this loop is doing now 3 times the work of the original iteration. For this once unrolled loop, the instructions would look like this. We would have the actual work of the one iteration. These are the same instructions as here. We now want to do this work once more. This would be this. However, if we just copy the instructions again, we would be doing the same work twice. We would just add R3 again to our same element A of I. So instead, we will adjust the offset here so that we are accessing the element right below the one that R1 is pointing to. This would be the A of I minus 1. And now we need our loop counter update and the actual loopback branch, but those we cannot simply copy. Just like here, we had to update the counter to count by 2 iterations. In this code, we were decrementing R1 to move to the element below. Now we're processing 2 elements at a time, so we need to move 8 bytes at a time. So the approach to unrolling once is take the original work, copy it twice, adjust the second copy so that it does the second iteration's worth of work, and then adjust the loop count so that it's moving by 2 iterations, not by 1. This is what it means to unroll once. So keep in mind that when we are doing 2 iterations at a time, we have unrolled the loop once because we have added 1 iteration of the original loop in addition to what the iteration normally would be doing. Unrolling twice would mean that we are doing 3 iterations at a time. Unrolling 3 times means that we are doing 4 times the work, and so on. It is a very common mistake that when you're asked to unroll the loop twice, unroll it this way. This is unrolling only once. Again, unrolling twice is not do 2 iterations at a time, it's do 1 plus 2 iterations at a time, because you always have to do 1 iteration. So this loop is not unrolled once, it is not unrolled at all. This is unrolled once.